the freedom to own property, it gave them the freedom to engage in business. That's what bourgeois systems and bourgeois revolutions do. They encourage people to pursue their own activities and to try and get richer without caring too much about politics, except for the efforts, of course, of activists, trade unionists, and others. But ultimately, the result is that in a capitalist system, the liberal democracy, people basically outsource the running of affairs, the understanding of big questions, to elites in one way or another, through political elections and a variety of other ways. So I think also that's, I mean, it goes back to something somebody was saying this morning. Are we talking about socialism or capitalism? I think at the stage we are talking about capitalism, and of course, the kinds of development strategies that are available under capitalism, I'd be the first one to say, are extremely limiting when you think of an ideal society, but that they are what they are. If we want to think of something else, something better, I think we definitely have to think of something that doesn't entail capitalism.
Thank you.
And
that brings to a
close
the conference.
I think it was fun, interesting. I hope you had fun, and now I think we can go and have a drink. There's a cocktail, which I think is highly needed, huh?